Second is the word Huma. Almighty Allah has used the zamir of two. This is personal noun, zamir. But Huma means this personal noun of tasniya for two, used for Holy Prophet and Almighty Allah together. This is not permissible for anybody else other than Prophet with Allah. This negates the concept of similarity. Nobody is similar to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is Khalik, the Creator. We are His slaves and servants. This is not against the etiquettes of divine statements that a slave, name of a slave is mentioned in togetherness with the name of this Lord. The Lord, the Master and the slave, they are never mentioned together and said both. Almighty Allah never mentions His name together with the name of any of His slaves, any of His servants. He always segregates and separates the nouns and personal nouns for Himself and for the slaves and servants and for the ibad, except for Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a great classical point to be understood, literal, classical point. He did not say here, in Quran he stated, as Habba ilaykum min Allahi wa Rasooli. But here in mentioning the personal noun, he has combined both in one word. That these both should be dearer to him than anything of this world. So it means that putting together in one word, mentioning together in the form of one zamir, mentioning Allah and His Messenger, mentioning Allah and His Rasul together in the form of one zamir, zamir of tasniya, this is only permissible for Allah and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and not for anybody else. Here lies the secret of Huma. In the same way as Almighty Allah stated in Holy Quran, Almighty Allah reveals His blessings on mu'mineen, reveals His salat on mu'mineen. It is stated in Holy Quran, هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. This is, it is Allah who reveals His blessings. يُصَلِّي, صِيغَ لِلْوَاحِدِ. Allah reveals and sends His blessings on you. وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ, wow, atifa. And then he mentioned the malaika, the angels, separately. It means, huwa yusalli alaykum wa malaikatuhu yusalluna alaykum. Hadha al-ibara taqdiriyah. And he says, yusalli alaykum. This is for singular. Singular verb. Singular tense. That it is He who sends His blessings on you. And of course His angels also send the blessings or pray for you. لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. He separates. Now, at other, this is for the mu'mineen, for the faithful. He has kept the angels separate from His act. Because He is mentioning the faithful, mu'mineen. And when comes the aspect of mentioning of His beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ, brings the angels before the verb. When He mentions the mu'mineen, He places the verb, singular verb, before and brings the world of angels afterward to separate and segregate the both. He doesn't want himself and the angels to be declared as both. He doesn't want to put himself with angels together. He has separated, segregated. But when comes the concept of the blessings on his beloved Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he changes the way. He says, "Inna Allah wa malaikatahu." Here is waw al musharrika. There was the waw al atifa. Here is musharrika lit tashriq. He says, "Inna Allah wa malaikatahu." He puts the angels together with him. Indeed, Allah and his angels, yusalluna ala nabi, together they send the salawat on my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He joins them in this verb for Holy Prophet, and he separates them from the verb for the mu'mineen. This is a special privilege given to Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and nobody else in this world possesses this kind of privilege. So here he says, "Ahabba ilayya mimma siwahuma." The both, yani Allah and Prophet, they both should be dearer to him than anything else of the world. So the way of saying indicates that how closer he wants to be his beloved Prophet with him. How closer and nearer and dearer he thinks him with him, to him. So he mentions his name and says the both. He puts his name together and we are here to separate them. To protect Tawheed, we are always trying to separate them. For the safeguard of so-called Tawheed, we are always worried for separating them, for differentiating them, for segregating them, the mating them, making them apart, departing them. This is our Tawheed, and that is Allah's Tawheed, that he always puts his beloved's name with him, and he puts in Huma. He always puts his name with him. This is the love of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah together. Through this verse, you know, three qualities have been mentioned. And under the first quality, it has been said that the love of both, yani Allah and his Prophet, should be, they both should be dearer to him than anything else in this world. This is the first quality, one. Quality number one. It means that if this aspect has been made the first quality, it means that love of Allah and love of the Messenger is one and the same. Now this is the next point. Love of Allah is not different than love of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And love of the Messenger is not something different from the love of Allah. In words, these are two different things. But in meanings, love of Allah and love of Prophet Muhammad is one and the same reality. This is the first quality.